Welcome back from the break. This is Skizzy on Urban TV. Y'all still hanging with the crown boy, Timothy Code, taking you all the way to 7 p.m. Shows brought to you by Star Times Channel 230. Catch all that magic on Urban TV this festive season. And Coca-Cola, taste the feeling, taste the season. Buy a bottle for your family, for your friends, for your girlfriend, for your ex, for your next. I don't care. Just buy them a bottle for Coca-Cola this season. Now, joining me on set today is, how do I introduce this man? The boy's from Tandale. Tandale is a place in Tanzania, right? You've also had that same title as the title of Diamond's next album. I think it's actually been released already, but we'll find out if it's released or not yet and what's in the works. But this man has a very close connection to Diamond, closer than anyone you could possibly imagine, and possibly even closer than Zari. You know why? Because I'm talking to Diamond's older brother, Romy Jones, or as he likes to say, Deejay RJ.
What's going on, boy?
How you doing, G?
I'm great. I'm grateful. Alhamdulillah. Yeah, that's what I say.
Nice, nice. But I want to learn, is there a difference between Swahili and Kenya and Tanzania? Because I'm learning how to, like, introduce to the people at home. Like, how would I say, you know, welcome to Skizzy. My name is Timothy.
You know, in Swahili,
yeah,
we're speaking too fast.
Yeah.
Like, you see, you flowing in English,
yeah,
flowing in Swahili.
I know.
Hey, mambo vipi, poa, I'm in Romy Johnson, angalia, like, Urban TV.
Yeah, I'd never.
Nobody can do that in here.
Yeah.
Try on.
I'd know. Mambo vipi, what? Nah. I'll take my lessons. Right. But welcome to Uganda. How you feeling, man?
Bro, I'm feeling great. It's a little bit hot, but I'm feeling the vibe, man.
But not your first time. This isn't your first time in Uganda.
Second time. First time was at Zaire party. Second time, same place, same thing.
Mm.
Yeah.
Now, you're Diamond's older brother and official DJ.
Yeah.
Let's get to know the brother side. Mm. Now, take us back to the back in the days, because everyone has seen Diamond's come up. Mm. Everyone knows Diamond, you know, well, back in the day, he wasn't balling.
Yeah, I know, right?
But now, take us back as brothers. Mm. How did you come up? How was the background story? What's the background story for the two of you, both you and Diamond?
The background story, TV and radio presenter
once
before Diamond doing anything.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So from there, I was like, Diamond was a singer a long time ago,
back
underground, undercover, you already know.
Yeah.
So I was like taking him up.
Yeah.
Like, yo, I'm a radio and TV presenter. You just come, you're going to use my back.
Yeah.
Understand? So from there, my TV and radio station didn't work out.
Yeah.
So I decided to, like, yo, right now, we're going to be together in this journey.
Mm-hmm.
So from there till now.
Till now. Time. So from you're the one who was in media. You were in TV and radio before.
I was the one who was pulling.
Pulling Diamond up, basically just pulling him on your back. Like, I have a platform. Mm-hmm. Let's make it work.
Let's do it.
Now, had he made that decision to be a singer before you joined media? Or maybe he saw Big Bro doing his thing and he's like, you know what?
Actually.
Yeah.
Before I was radio and TV presenter.
Yeah.
He was a singer.
Oh.
But, like, how can he, like, can he come out?
Yeah.
Like, yo, Romy, you know, I don't have any connection. I don't know what to do. Like, I love music, but I don't know how to do it.
Yeah.
I mean, and I was like, okay, I didn't even know how to help him.
Yeah.
But automatically, just.
As a brother, you're like, I need to. All right.
I had to deal with one of the best TV and radio station in Tanzania.
Yeah.
So from there, like, yo, let's roll together.
All right. Mm. What's your earliest childhood memory of the two of you as brothers? Who was beaten more at home? You or Diamond?
Actually, him.
Him.
It was too
crazy. Diamond. All right.
It was too crazy.
What were your earliest childhood memories?
The memories, you know, the first song
from
Diamond.
Yeah.
He took his mom's ring.
Yeah. And sold it. Oh, God. All right. Take a seat.
Yeah. So the money from the ring.
Yeah.
He go and record the first track.
Was this the wedding ring?
Actually, nah.
No, it's okay. Just a ring. Okay.
That's a gold ring.
Okay.
That's what was crazy, mom.
So he took mom's ring, sold it. Oh, man.
And go for the first track.
Yeah.
And I was in the video.
Yeah.
The song is called Tokamwanza, if you've been.
Tokamwanza, yeah.
Yes. If you watch the video.
Okay. So now, let's fast forward into time now. You decided, you know, let me leave TV and radio and let me become his official DJ. How did you transition from being a media personality to becoming a DJ for Diamond?
Because when I was at the media.
Yeah.
You know, it's a big company.
Yeah.
There's a lot of DJs. There's a lot of presenters. There's a lot of everything. Everybody. Yeah. So the time I was presenting, I was just I was into DJing.
Yes.
I was just learning from some big guys, big fishes. Like, how do you do this? How do you do that?
Yeah.
So after dropping the TV and radio station, they just dropped me down because there are some mistakes.
Yeah.
So, I've been like telling Diamond, listen, you know, we have to work together.
Mm-hmm.
But we should work like, I work with you as Wu.
Yeah.
As a manager.
Yeah.
Nah. As a like tour guide, whatever.
Nah.
Let's do this for now because we don't have enough capital.
Yeah.
You understand? Let me be your official DJ.
Official DJ.
Like you go to the concert,
I'll be the guy who's at the back. Yeah.
Thing.
Yeah.
Make sure that this song is gonna be.
Yeah.
You understand what I mean?
I get it. Yes.
That's always what.
Now let's understand the role of an official DJ because all of these artists, especially even here in Uganda, one by one, they've started picking out DJs that they want to become their official DJs. Now, like Maurice Kiria has DJ Joe. What is your take on the role of an official DJ? What does he do? What impact does he have on the artist when he's performing?
Actually, for the artist to have an official DJ,
it's
a really good thing because you guys should have a chemistry first.
Yes.
You understand? The chemistry.
Yes.
You can't even do a rehearsal together. If you have a chemistry and if you know your artist songs, you know all of them. So if he's going to perform on a stage, you know, like, this is supposed to be like mute. This is supposed to be like.
Yeah. If he wants, you know, to listen from the crowd. Yeah.
So if you don't have a DJ, you just go to the show like, hey, yo, can you play my song? This is my flash. And
it's like, toop. Nah.
Not that song, please. No,
yeah. I know. Now imagine, say, like Diamond in particular. Mm-hmm. If he's on stage and he says, I want to perform Eneka before Zigo. And then you play Zigo before, it's like.
That's unprofessional.
Bro. Very unprofessional.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And for the DJ,
as
for me, behind the turntable, behind the Diamond's music.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, you know, we have to be very careful
because
Diamond is a big artist.
Yes.
So I'm taking everything. I'm taking his risk.
Yes.
Because I'm the everything right there.
Yes. At that point in time, you are building both your brand and his brand. You're holding his brand.
Already know.
Yes.
At the same time, so you have to be smart, concentrated in one thing.
Mm. I like that. Ugandan artists, let's start hustling for DJs. Find yourself an official DJ who knows your set because he knows Diamond's set better than anyone.
I think you should find your friend first.
Yes, find a friend first.
Yeah.
Then possibly if you're friends and he's a DJ, then that works. Now, let's talk about your tours with Diamond. Diamond has performed in, I think, over 40 or 50 countries now.
Definitely.
What is your favorite experience away from Tanzania performing? We'll even get into Uganda, but away from Tanzania, what are your favorite countries, the biggest shows that you've enjoyed?
You know, actually, first, let me tell you one thing.
Mm.
There is this show, like, it's officially Diamond's show.
Yes.
Like, there's no other artist.
Yes.
You understand?
Where he's the headliner.
Yes.
Yes.
Only Diamond. So maybe from 9 till midnight, it's Diamond's. So I'm going to be the first DJ to play some music, maybe for 1 hour.
Yes.
And if there is some other artist,
yes,
maybe he's gonna perform Navio, or Navio is perform maybe Eddie Kenzo, from Eddie Kenzo is perform Diamond.
Yeah.
From there, I can't do anything.
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for Diamond. Like, yo, start with it.
Okay.
First song, then to the end.
Yeah.
So I don't do anything.
Yeah.
But if you have our own show, I'm gonna start playing
top to bottom.
You already know.
Yeah.
My favorite tracks.
Yeah.
So the place I will never forget was in you know, we did this Europe tour from Tandale to the world.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Yes. That was our own tour. Our own.
Oh, so you were in control of the music. Mm-hmm. All right.
Nobody, like, okay.
This act is coming,
nah.
All right.
RJ, be the artist. Be the first one
to
warm up.
Yeah.
Then that one's coming.
All right.
So we did good in Germany, as in Belgium.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I had 10 minutes.
To mash people up. I'd love to see it. I'd love to see a DJ walk a crowd even before the artist steps on. You know Diamond is stepping on, but RJ DJ has to step in one time just to get you guys ready. Now, away from all that, now let's talk about the music. Personally, as Diamond's brother, what's your favorite Diamond Platinum song?
There is...
Actually, give me a top five because Diamond has very many.
Five,
give me a top five.
There's this new song, Eneka.
Eneka?
It has a very massive beat and everything. But there is Mapenzi Basi. Mapenzi Basi. Mapenzi Basi in our playlist.
Yeah.
You know, we have like 32, 35 songs.
Yeah.
If you play like This Is Diamond's Show.
Yes.
We have like 40 or like 35 songs.
35 to 40, yeah.
So Mapenzi Basi, it's a fifth song from there.
Oh, from the start.
We started like from the slow songs and like, yo, this one.
And then?
So from Mapenzi Basi,
Raising the tempo, like, yeah.
So Mapenzi Basi and Eneka. There is this Ukimwona. Yeah, there's Ukimwona, there is some relax. You know what I'm saying? This nigga, you know, is very good in relax.
Yes, I've heard Diamond is very crazy with the pen.
This three tones, right?
Yes, that's true.
Mawazo. There's some, you know, I love beats.
Yeah. I know, as a DJ, that's your preference. You want to make sure that people are banging.
Mawazo, and then Waka Waka. Trap, man.
I know, man. When everyone saw that collaboration, they were like, the boy's taking over in America now. Now, what would you say is Diamond's plans for, you know, Africa? Because we haven't had the chance to speak to him directly, but what would you say Diamond's plans for Africa, like the takeover?
I can't speak on behalf that much, but I think he's done with a lot of artists in Africa.
Is he going to take over Nigeria? Is he going to take over South Africa?
Maybe he's going to take over maybe U.S.
U.S.
Starting with the Ricky Rolls.
Yeah.
It's just
the beginning, yeah.
Marion,
yeah.
Soon we'll be out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Africa is just. It's done with Africa.
Back. Yeah.
Yeah, there's some different.
The
songs
sound is. Yeah. Yeah. I agree, because now we're looking at Africa to the world. Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. Now, you know, the big dude, you're here in UG. Zari, All White Party.
Your party.
You're the official DJ and you're stepping in. What can we expect if Diamond actually shows up? What can we expect from you guys tonight?
Actually,
if
Diamond is coming,
yeah,
he won't perform.
He won't perform.
This is the party.
Yes,
I'm gonna perform as a DJ.
Yes.
If you're at home right now, just come to the Zari White Party at Governor tonight.
Yeah.
And you will see what I'm talking about.
All right. If you what we've been talking about, you need to see the man in action. All right.
You'll never sit down. I believe in myself, my friend.
No, but that's what a DJ is supposed to be. Like, if an artist is a singer, is one who creates the songs, the DJs use the songs to keep the party going. So I believe in that.
Actually, let me tell you one thing. I don't have a specific genre. I don't have like this is the type of song I play.
Yeah.
I'm just playing maybe rag only. I'm just playing maybe R&B only.
No.
I'm just playing all hits.
All right. Only hits.
Your favorite. I'm playing your favorite songs.
All right. Maybe you're going to open up a label here in UG. Maybe sign a few artists. You never know.
Actually, in Tanzania, WCB Wasafi, we have this platform. It's called wasafi.com.
For the music platform.
Yeah, digital platform. If an artist from Uganda, send us the email. Our email address is info@wasafi.com.
Yeah, okay.
Send us your song and maybe your what? We'll send you the contract.
Yeah.
You see the contract, then from there we start a business.
Yeah.
You understand?
All right.
Apart from that, as RJ the DJ, I'm having an upcoming project this January.
Yes.
I'll be taking an artist from Uganda, Nigeria, from maybe Europe.
Yeah.
Then put them together maybe in a one song.
Yeah.
So I'll be doing that.
Yeah, more and more collaborations.
So maybe if you're the good artist here.
I'm just saying, man, DJ Khaled has been putting all these artists together. Why not DJ RJ?
We already know.
All right.
Stay tuned for that.
All right, we'll see you guys tonight at the All White Party at Governor. Zari will be there. DJ RJ will be there. He'll be playing. You need to come through and see how the boys from Tandale do their thing on the ones and twos. Bro. Thanks for coming through, man.
Bro, thanks, bro.
Send some love. Just send some love, man.
RJ the DJ, baby. See you tonight, man. Zari White Party, baby.
We out.
Holla.